Universities that are truly at the top of the chain tends to be known not only for their research, but also for other things such as the impact on the discipline. This is an institution that really sets the state of the art.
I make microfluidic devices that can be very useful for developing personalized medicine. I'm a tool developer, and that's the core that mechanical engineers can provide. We know how to design, how things move, how to make it more efficient.
Currently, we have funding from the Air Force to look at how to control flows over aircraft wings using computer simulation software. But we are able to take those same simulation tools and apply that to understand how blood clots form in the heart, how birds fly, how insects move about.
These are interesting materials that not a lot of people know how to characterize and model. And that's what we do, is we figure out how they work by developing new techniques to study the mechanics of the eye.
We're interested in trying to develop a more scientific fundamental understanding of what we call our human haptic perception or our human touch perception. If you're interested in the medical robotics field, I would say that Hopkins actually can't be beat.
I was really interested in coming to Hopkins because of its very large interdisciplinary action. Not only do you work inside the department, you work outside the department and even far-reaching to companies and research institutions. When you work in industry, you have to be able to talk to the average person as well as the scientific person, which I don't think as a graduate student I really appreciated until I had to do both.
What sets us apart is our ability to apply these tools to a wide variety of problems and also take advantage of the incredible opportunities for collaboration that exist in a place like Johns Hopkins. Any research project that you can think of and you're looking for a collaborator, there's a good chance that you'll find the world's expert in that topic right here in Hopkins.
Coming to Johns Hopkins has allowed me to kind of take my career in any direction, whether I want to work in academia, go to industry, or maybe a national lab. I have all of those opportunities, and I've been able to work with someone in every one of those disciplines to kind of get a feel for what I want to do.
My student will learn a lot of experimental skills, but in addition to that, they'll interact with my collaborating doctors so that they understand the real problem that they have to tackle when they establish their career.
I work very closely with my students. We meet every week. They'll get a lot of personal attention, a lot of guidance and mentorship. I usually know the ins and outs of their work in the beginning. Later on, they'll know much more than I will.
Very quickly, you know, students become the leaders on these projects, the thought leaders on these projects. And that's the kind of environment that we try to foster here.
Johns Hopkins has set me up to be successful in terms of my career, academically, as well as in real world experience.
I anticipate that there's going to be a lot of things happening here in the future, and I think it's being exciting to be a part of that.